For my action research project, I host a weekly Bible study meeting over the course of 3 weeks for my teammates and friends. For my action research book, I chose to read Sum It Up, 1,098 Victories, A Couple of Relevant Losses, and A Life in Perspective by Pat Summitt with Sally Jenkins. In this book, Pat Summitt talks about her life as a whole, including her Hall of Fame coaching career at the University of Tennessee. She discusses her struggles throughout her life, including her recent diagnosis with Alzheimer's, and how these events shaped her life. This book relates to my mission statement because Pat Summitt handles very similar things, such as basketball, family, and religion, that I find myself at times struggling with and hope to improve on throughout my life. One quote that stuck out to me from Pat's book was a statement she made saying, "I know there's something I'm supposed to be doing. There's something God wants me to do." This quote caught my attention because it shows that even in her success, she was never complacent at obtaining her goals in other aspects of her life. By hosting these Bible studies, I was not only able to help myself to focus on one of my own goals, but I was able to also help my friends and teammates to do the same. To begin our first Bible study, I handed out surveys in order to gauge exactly how consistent my peers were in their own faith. After filling out the forms, we sat down and discussed some goals that we may have had and asked questions as to how we would be able to attain these goals. Once we established our goals, we went over any learning outcomes we hoped to get out of the Bible studies. Once we established our learning outcomes, we decided that the book of James would be best suited for our discussions from that point. Throughout the Bible study, the group formulated some great questions that led to intimate conversations that helped us to solve some common problems that we all had. One of the things I found interesting was by addressing these problems as a unit, we found various ways to approach similar issues. Following our Bible studies, I invited the group to attend Fellowship of Christian Athletes, also known as FCA, an organization especially for student athletes to attend weekly for a group Bible study. Mary Grabowski, the FCA leader, operated as my triple loop study, and she gave me very positive feedback, pointing out that I had very useful insight from my group, and suggested that I also try to challenge the group more with more difficult questions rather than just interpreting the passages. As a student athlete, it is easy to get caught up on just that, being solely a one-dimensional student athlete. One lesson that I took away from my action research project came from the insight of Pat Summitt. She insisted that people assume because that she was successful in one area of her life, that the rest of her life was perfectly intact. I learned that focusing in on just one aspect of my life wouldn't be sufficient enough in order to consider myself a true success. As a son and older brother, it will be beneficial to myself, family, and peers to become the best person I can be in a variety of subjects.